Alright then.
Everyone, hello, and welcome back to another episode of Brave New World Blindfolded. So, in this episode, well, I'm taking on the one and only Abba weapon, I guess. So, just my party loadout for a second. I've got Realm pretty much stacked as much for magic as possible. I mean, I obviously can't equip a rod or I can't sketch. You may be thinking, oh, well, I could use a rod setup and do crits and 4,000 damage a proc, but actually it doesn't beat sketch. It's not a good idea compared to sketch because not only does it do, even if I proc like half the time or something like that, I'd have to proc much more than half the time to be able to outdo sketch, because with sketch I can be in the back row, nice and safe, but with the rods I have to be in the front row and I have to watch her MP, because obviously if her MP runs out, then she's not doing any critical hits. This just makes it so much easier, and it does about 2300 damage a flare, so that's what you can sketch from Abba weapon if you didn't know. Second place is Raze, which is still decent, but not nearly as good, only about 1400. But it's 25% chance of sketching that, so it doesn't factor in too much. And also there's the fact that the rods get weaker after he applies shell and safe and stuff. That's just not good. So next is Setzer. He's got the switchblade for extra speed, as well as some gold stuff, I guess. And he's got the green beret because I want his HP a little bit higher. The thing is, with the green beret, it actually helps him survive things like flare. Otherwise, he's only surviving flare some of the time, and he's not going to level before he reaches Atma weapon. These two might. It would help a lot if Realm leveled. It wouldn't hurt if Celeste leveled too, but, or rather, Cell, I suppose. For Shadow, we've got Ninja. I mean, that's pretty much all there is to say. Ninja. And for Cell, we've got the Ice Brand, obviously, as well as the Mystery Veil. It's just better than the Gold Helm. Physical attacks are kind of just a blip on my radar for this fight, as far as I'm concerned, so the defense is probably the most worthless out of all of these stats here. And now for Relics, Amulet and Wall Ring. Now, normally I wouldn't use amulets for Atma weapon. Personally, my normal strat is speed and magic block all the way, because if you're taking like 6 turns to his 1, and one person's probably got the ribbon, and the other 3 have a decent chance of dodging the Mind Blast, and you're taking 6 turns anyway. Mind Blast is honestly more free turns, even if you don't have an amulet. That's what I've always found going through this fight. But each to their own, I guess. I know other people don't usually like to stray from the safety of their amulets, but oh yeah, and since white capes provide, you guessed it, speed and magic evasion, you're going to be protected from some statuses anyway, so in my experience, it usually fails on the guy with the ribbon. One person ends up dodging it. One person usually ends up getting inflicted with only statuses that don't matter much. So you're spending like one turn healing some of the like other status effects in this fight per Mind Blast, and that's not a big deal, to be honest, to me anyway. Confuse can be an issue, but we've also got Realm. I pretty much just shoved magic points on her. She's just magic all the way, so that I can just max out that damage because I need it. Similarly, Shadow's got the Power Glove, which isn't quite as effective. I'm not even 100% sure that's the best choice, but I know his throwing attacks will do a lot worse. Speaking of throwing attacks, I didn't do a very good job of stocking up on those, as I probably mentioned earlier before the Floating Continent, so I've got the whopping 12 shurikens left over from whenever I bought shurikens for some reason. Maybe for Zozo. I can't remember. Maybe they were dropped on the felt. I'm not even sure. The other thing I'm missing that would be helpful is Gaia gear. I think that would outdo the ninja gear, and I'm pretty sure it would outdo the ninja gear here. And it would definitely have that earth damage like the Tabby Hide does for Realm, which is really handy because it allows them to survive Life Shaver, for one. Quake and Magnitude, hopefully I'll be hovering over that most of the time. And if I'm not, the character who's getting hit with it is probably going to die whether they're having earth damage or not, so it's not a bit as big a deal there, but definitely for Life Shaver. It's too bad I don't have the Gaia gear for Shadow. I've shoved Seraph on Setzer. Summoning this takes a while, so it's kind of awkward, and it also takes a lot of MP up. That's the thing about Re-Rise, it costs more MP than I want to expend on this fight right now, because MP's kind of tight. I'm kind of going no hold bars on the items to begin with, but if I start using Re-Rise, I suspect it will be more trouble than it's worth keeping it up. So, if I had someone like Gao spamming Re-Rise, I would be okay, but ironically, because normally I wouldn't like Gao with Re-Rise because I don't like not being able to target things like that. And I guess the last thing for me to talk about, after I show my controller slots, I left it the same as for the rest of the Floating Continent. Celeste is probably the most complicated of the characters. Definitely can't have Celeste and Setzer on the same wavelength there, because if they're both in the same controller slot, it gets really hard to tell the difference when runic and slots don't make any noise when you move the cursor around. And so we've got Remedy and Phoenix down. On my test runs, these were in the top two, and it just kind of got ingrained in my mind, so that's how I'm remembering that. Tonics are... I almost said Tanics, I was making fun of the Sanic joke, but Tonics are in the third slot because they're the quintessential healing item. I just put these three in alphabetical order, they're all kind of same-ish. I don't think I'll be using those, but I know where they are, just in case I happen to think, boy, I need a Phoenix tier right now. And Tinctures, because I'll be using those after the battle. I don't think I'll be using anything else for my inventory. In fact, I know I won't, because I don't know where any of them are. So I'll save for absolutely no reason, and I suppose we can get on with it. No more ninjas on the way to Atma Weapon, please. It's just getting me more of a pain in the butt every time I do it. Well, it's Life Shaver. That means... Yeah, I'm pretty sure it's three of those guys. Alright, this is Shadow. This is Realm. Alright, that should finish him off, because Celeste already hit him with an ice too, so he should be going down the toilet any second now. Is this Celeste or Shadow? This is Shadow. Go away, Shadow. You suck. This is Celeste. It's gotta be. Did I reset Shadow's cursor position? I didn't. I should avoid that. Oh, Shadow. Don't go counterattacking, please. You're just wasting my damage. You Shadow or Celeste? You are Shadow. An attack would be much appreciated. Yeah! Airship time! Now, if only you could pick me up straight after the Floating Continent, that would make this a lot easier. Are you dead? You are, in fact, not dead. Burn that thing to death. For some reason, I'm imagining this battle as a back attack. And yeah, it's weird. I didn't even really consciously register that it was a back attack. I was just kind of imagining it that way. So, no one was blinded. Actually, kind of surprising for that battle. Nobody died, which is unsurprising for that battle. and someone was hurt. They go and mess with that. That's not how I'm supposed to do things yet. Shouldn't have been dashing and left and upping, but I guess that was a pretty secure spot anyway. I was already most of the way up. All the way up. Which wasn't very far because it's battle, you know. Attack. This is probably realm. Actually, that'll tell me nothing. Okay, this is Setzer, actually. Something perma died. Now this is realm, sketch. Celeste attack. Man, Shadow's going nuts here. Watch, he's gonna kill the third enemy before anything even happens. Oh, it's a gargoyle. Well, nothing's gonna happen anyway whether Shadow kills the third enemy or not. Nope, Shadow did not do anything, but it doesn't matter because gargoyles cannot do anything on their own. They're pretty much like the tanky healers or something. As long as I have float at any rate, which I do. But yeah, this is like fighting a white mage on its own. Which isn't very difficult in most games. Not that you do that in most games, because seriously, who makes a white mage boss? Probably the default Kof-Kof. Though of course that one was following something of a pattern. Airship. I will be seeing you later, Mr. Airship. Probably multiple times during the Atma weapon fight, but I will be seeing you again after that, too. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4. A route planned out. This part of the route is actually planned out to make it really easy to come backwards. 1, 2, 3. Which is kind of ironic, in a way. Alright, I really want to... Oops, I don't remember whether I left it on save or... Yeah. So one thing I really want is to make sure that I don't get a battle after Atma Weapon. Like, 2 steps after Atma Weapon, so I'm going to walk back and forth a bit. It wouldn't have happened anyway, apparently, but, you know, it doesn't hurt to be careful. And I walk left and right instead of up and down, because if I walk up and down, I may accidentally enter the fight going into the menu after this fight, and that would be bad news. Alright. Why am I pausing so much? I could just mash A, like my plan kind of is right now. Oh. Well, that's 1,000 damage. Quake, that does nothing. Because no one's died yet, and that's the only way these guys are going to be removing it. Well, that's one enemy incapacitated probably for the rest of the fight. That's one enemy dead probably for the rest of the fight. Unless I really, really mess something up. Actually, it might not even be possible. I don't even think I have to revive him because I don't even think I have Muddle. And a Muddle plus Phoenix down plus 1 out of 3 chance would be the only way of that thing being revived, which I suppose is not something anybody would be interested in doing at any rate. Have I defeated the fight? Yes, I have. Remedy, just to make sure, even though I'm absolutely certain that I did not require that remedy. And I was indeed correct. Minor healing. Whoop-dee-doo. And it's time to enter the battle. Alright. Hopefully, for the last time, I fought you too many times by now, and not even necessarily because I died all those times fighting you. Alright, so this is Shadow or Celeste. This is Shadow. Out of the way, Shadow. You're in my way. This is Celeste. Let's scroll down to the bottom. Haste is not what I want. 2, 1, 2, 3. So you either realm on sketch or Setzer on slot. You're a realm on sketch. Please do what you were born to do, realm. Setzer, put region on yourself to make sure things go smooth as butter, and realm, boil this thing very painfully as well. I'd much prefer it if it's painful. Now hopefully that hits, but there will be no way to tell for a few turns at least. Alright, let's just wait for a bit. Rasp. It's a pain in the butt, but there's nothing I can do about it yet. Slow him. And Setzer. I'm doing the slow as sort of a safety slow. I had one run where slow missed both times, and then I ended up dying because of it. This time I am at least considering it within the realm of possibility, within the realm, haha, very funny, of possibility. So I'll have my ear out for it, at any rate. Aww. Alright, so let's see. Is this Celeste? Celeste should be on Celeste should be on magic because you were slowing. Yes, I was correct, it is Celeste. Indeed. Shadow attacked. Let's see if Realm sketches. Realm is dead. Phoenix down, Realm. And Setzer, you should be on magic still. So cure to it up once Realm is revived. Shadow, you attack. Actually, I should have thrown a tonic on Realm in hindsight, rather than send Shadow out to do minor damage just to keep up with the region. Actually, in hindsight, Float would have ended up even better. I should have just bided my time, but whatever. We have Realm at the ready, because there's no way Setzer would have beaten her to the punch when he used the Cure 2. This should be Celeste. She used a Phoenix down. Scroll all the way down the bottom. Actually, why did I say that Shadow should have used a Cure 2 on Realm when... I mean, a tonic on Realm when I was using Cure 2, and that was the point of healing. Alright, so this should be Setzer pulling up the rear with his magic of some kind, which is going to be region. I know that Rasp probably did not hit Setzer because he can still cast Seraph. This is Shadow. I'll have you wait. Float's back up and ready. What? Oh no. At last, he may have thrown a Gravaga out this turn or the last turn, and it's hard to tell which one's Gravaga and which one's Float. I mean, Purge. Why would he cast Float on me? Durr. It makes it hard to tell what exactly I should be doing here. But I'll hit as many bases as possible. I'll have region on Celeste, and Setzer might take care of issues if, you know. Sketch him, please. Now, Setzer, hurry it up already. Wait. This will be a good test if he's on slow or not. I think if he's on slow, Celeste should get the turn in first, but if he's not on slow, Celeste... Oh, ow. Okay. I'm starting to fear that slow did not connect. This is a magic menu, right? You are Setzer, correct? I shall be dropping a Cure 2 on the party, because I do not know my condition as far as that's concerned. You are probably Shadow. I do believe you are. Just double check and attack. Sketch. You are definitely Shadow. Wait outside of the menu, because it doesn't buy any realm extra time to not do that. Oh, sweet. So, this should be Celeste. Should be on magic. As expected, 2 up to attack. And because he gave me a free turn, I can even have Setzer go and do some attacking and just say hello to whatever that is I just did. Attack with the proc. Sketch him. It should be Shadow. Alright, now just go on a streak of ground attacks, please, like you did last time, and let me have a whole ton of free turns. Would be much appreciated. Oh yeah, right. I gotta deal with the whole purge every so often thing. Oh, well. This should be Celeste, and it should be on attack. Why did I do that? 2 down to nothing, because there's nothing in that slot. Durr. 1 down to that. I don't know where you are, so just scroll up to the top. And you region yourself as well, and bada boom, bada bing, it's free turns, because I can set everything up and still attack him on the same turn, so if that's the case, then it's pretty much just being scrubbed by doing that. I don't know if Shadow's going to be able to get his turn into attack, but hey, might as well try. More Flare. Flare is always appreciated, unless it's him using Flare, in which case it's not so appreciated. I suppose that defeats the purpose of the always. But alas, he did not use Flare, so we are getting Celeste just double-checked, and now we can do a Setzer. And then have Rome sketch again. This first phase is getting to be really, really easy by this point. As long as Slow connects, which it really, really should. Is this Shadow or Celeste? It is indeed Shadow. As long as Slow connects, this is pretty much just a cakewalk. It's the beginning of his second phase that's the most dangerous part of the fight. Really? I can at least tell if Shadow dies. Well, Shadow is not dead. Oh, whoops, that was dumb. That's not a menu. Alright, I'll use Cure 2, but I have to leave Setzer at the ready. Well, everyone survived. That's it. Murder him. Hopefully I get those attacks off still. I'm not sure. Aw, darn, I didn't. Dang it. I'll let you have your time. I get no real advantage from, buying time there, so I just decided to wait in the menu. And this is Celeste. Should be. She used Cure 2, so she's on magic. I think people are probably gonna... I think people are probably gonna start needing healing items in terms of the magic variety soon, so You accomplish nothing with your turn, congratulations. Realm is on the ready for sketching. Celeste. Sets are stolen slots, as expected. 1-2. And region yourself. Shadow, this should be your turn. You should be on magic still. So let us remedy Phoenix down, tonic, elixir, ether. I do not need to be throwing elixirs yet. Realm used raise, which is unfortunate. Alright, let's just leave that up for the moment. That in turn is snore-worthy. This is Realm. I'll just have her do stuff. Not gonna try any tricky business here. This is who? Celeste's Shadow. This is, in fact, Shadow. This is Celeste, obviously. Don't remember if she's got region or not. And Setsu should be coming up after that. I'll just have Setsu wait. And it's perhaps a good thing that I did. This is magic menu, correct? I gotta check if someone died. Oh shoot, Setsu's out. That is not good timing at all. There's a possibility that Setzer has taken massive damage from the Life Shaver, is on the verge of death, so I'm gonna use an elixir. Remedy, tonic, no, Phoenix Sound, tonic, elixir. Oh good, someone else's turn came up. This is who and where should you be? Celeste should be on Celeste should be on fight because I just had her attack. Okay, so this is Shadow. So the question is, Shadow, what do I want to do with you? I'm gonna check if Celeste is alive. What should I do with Setzer again? I had him elixir himself. Setzer's not dead. Realm can't have died, unless if she had already taken some damage from the physical attack and that topped her off. So I'm gonna check if Celeste is dead. I have an E-Phoenix down tonic. This should be Realm. Okay, Celeste is on her feet, so nobody died from that. It's kind of lucky. I'm gonna fire off a Cure 2 next turn to make sure everything's all fine and dandy, but for now I'll just wait. So this should be Celeste. You know, I'll wait outside the menu to not waste my animation time. Actually, I don't think it matters. She was probably on fight. One, two, three. Region. This should be Shadow. And so we shall cast some float. You are on item right now, so we scroll down to the bottom. And by we, I clearly mean I, because you are not playing. I am sorry, you are not playing. It is a fact of life. One that I cannot really control very well. You used an elixir, which is why I had to scroll up there, to make sure that you were in your item menu. And I'm being an idiot because I want you to cast region. 1, 2, 3, region yourself and go. Then Realm, you bring up the rear with your sketching prowess. Kind of wanted to fire off a Cure 2, but you know, that's just not going to happen. Get all the turns back in order. Let us move Shadow back to the fight command. raise. That's unfortunate, but not a complete disaster. Now he should be going next. Wait, what? Darn it, I'm getting mixed up between Graviga and Purge this run. I'm definitely going to have to fire off a Cure 2 now, because I don't know what condition my party is in, so someone's region is going to have to wait, and apparently it's going to be Celeste's. I'm just hoping that I'm guessing right about which order he used them in. And by guessing right, I mean not really much of a guess at all. It's more just a, I thought he used Purge last turn, but now I don't know whether he used Purge or Graviga last turn or not. Obviously no one's dead. And nobody is going to be at low HP thanks to that cure too, so I can at least eliminate all worries of that being the case. Raise again. Not a big deal in the first phase. That's only the second phase where I'm really going to start caring. You just used Rasp. Alright, so I'm going to have Shadow drop the X Ether now. Remedy, Phoenix Down, Tonic, Elixir, Ether, X Ether. Because I don't know my... I was worried about my MP position before, especially on Shadow, and that just made it worse, so I don't really know what's going on, so I'm going to drop the X Ether. I hear the noise, it came up, it's Celeste's turn, where is she? She's on magic. Where is she? Now I'm getting second thoughts. Yeah, she was. So your region is the one who I canned in favor of having to cure to, and so Stetzer is the one who will be attacking this turn. And then Realm, bring up the rear with a flare, and that's another set of attacks out of the way. You are Shadow and you are on item. Celeste is on magic. Realm's turn is nice because it buys me so much time for everyone else to come up. It's sort of like my... It sort of marks the end of the beginning of a cycle and the end of a cycle, if you know what I mean. Keeps everything in order, nice and fresh, and when things go awry and Realm dies, that's why things get hairy when Realm dies, actually. So this is Setzer. You shall be using your slots, because I don't see what else I'd be doing with you this turn. And Celeste, scroll up 2 to attack, and go for it. Thankfully he's immune to float and not... I mean, immune to Earth and not floating, so Chocobop works quite nicely on him. What? Did Celeste attack and I missed it? Maybe she missed and that's why I missed it. Oh wow, second phase time. I believe everyone should be at full. Phoenix Down, Tonic. I'm gonna have, should I do that? Yeah, I should, because obviously he'll get his turn coming up. The important thing is that I get him out of the way so I can tell when Celeste's turn comes up. She's on attack right now, and then I will scroll down to the bottom because I need to inflict slow on him as quickly as possible. This part of the fight gets really luck-reliant. Actually, one thing that's kind of funny, I'll scroll down to back to the bottom because I wasn't paying enough attention. I'm not 100% sure what I was doing. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. The funny thing is, one time during my testing, I actually had it where Purge just came out after he had already buffed himself, and that ended up making it so that he buffed himself again the turn after that. So Setzer, I'm going to leave you where you are, because you will be instrumental in getting everyone up onto their feet. I'd love it if Slow got off first, but that's a pipe dream, and I don't think it will happen. It did not, as completely expected. All Alright, please don't counter. Okay, good. He countered the last two times, and that made everything a whole lot worse to do. So now that you're on your feet, Shadow used a tonic on himself, mostly just to get himself out of the way more than anything else. You revive, please. Remedy, Phoenix Down, Tonic, Elixir, Ether, X Potion. Actually, I'm not sure. I might have pressed right by accident there once, and I really don't want to mess this turn up. Remedy, Phoenix Down, Tonic, Elixir, Ether, X Potion. Alright. So, this should be a litmus test. If Rom gets her sketch off first, then I have slowed him properly. Okay, she did not get her sketch off first. So either I'm completely lost on something. Oh, wait, why would Celeste come up first? I do not believe slow connected, so I shall be doing that. Realm sketch? Huh? Whose turn is this? I'm getting a little antsy to make sure that this is Shadow like I think it is. And good thing he wasn't on Imp, because that would have made a mess of things. Remedy yourself, if you would please. And this should be Setzer, and he should be on item because I used a Phoenix Down last turn. So what do I want to do? Oh yeah, what I usually do here. It's to Remedy Realm. Alright, now I'm really hoping slow connected. So this should be Realm. Alright, just wait. I may in fact drop an X potion with her turn. Maybe I'm just being antsy. Is that necessary or is it not necessary? I'm going to stop being paranoid, because paranoid can be just as dangerous as being paranoid and cautious can be just as dangerous as being gutsy sometimes. Elixir, Ether, X Potion. I'll have you do it. And I shall have you cast Float to get that up and going. So you should be on definitely either magic or items. It's magic. Raise, that's a bummer. Haste, 1-2 up to Float. Says it's not going to make it in time for the region. Alright, just wait. And hope that it did not hit Realm. Or Shadow. Best case scenario is that it hit Setzer. Uh-oh, it may have hit Shadow because... I mean, Realm. Because Shadow's turn came up. I'm going to assume that is the case. Or did Realm just sketch? Shadow is pretty fast. What did I do? I'm gonna wait for Setsu's Cure 2 to go off before I do anything at all. Aw, darn it. I was correct in my assessment earlier. Or not. It's Celeste that's dead. That's not good at all. I'm not sure how that happened, but... yeah, let's just have Rom wait for a second. I don't like doing this, but... okay, I probably don't need Rom to wait any longer. This should be Shadow. Alright, Setzer, you get ready to cure to everyone, and please get that off before he moves again. Tense moment here. I did not remedy, in hindsight, I did not remedy Celeste after the one mind blast, so I'm suspecting she died of poison or seizure. I mean, it wouldn't have helped with the seizure anyway, but poison, seizure are always a huge issue. He's probably going to mind blast this turn, so I want to leave Shadow's turn around, and I want to move him to item already, where he already is. Alright, I was indeed correct. Let's have you do that. Alright, Celeste lost... I mean, Rome lost control of her faculties. So she's definitely going to need the remedy that Setzer's going to throw on her this turn. Setzer? Okay, good, he showed up. Showed up to the party. Remedies realm. Remedy number three. What? Wasn't there supposed to be a third remedy in there? Oh, please don't be going wrong things. This is Rome. I don't know if it's safe to do that, but gotta keep the damage up at all hours of the day. That's how you do that. Let's double check whether you are Shadow or Celeste. Alright. Okay, that's good. It was Grav Bomb. Darn it. Well, Celeste is definitely the one who's dead. Unfortunately, I'm not going to buy myself a whole lot of time with that move. I need to have Rom sketch right away. How is he doing that? Did my slow double miss again? Celeste would definitely have died from that. Well, I mean, Setzer, get your curing going. Because I need Celeste alive to slow him. And please don't do anything troll-worthy. Oh, that is completely not troll-worthy. Especially since he didn't hit Realm. Okay, so... well, here's the thing. Where am I? This should be Shadow, I do believe. Celeste will need more healing than she got from that cure, too. So I shall be throwing a tonic on Celeste with Shadow. Celeste, you are on items, and I have to get that slow on before it actually makes a difference. Because... slow off this guy is a disaster. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. Slow him. In fact, I'm lucky I haven't died already at that rate. The Slav says her by it is time. Okay. Aura magic. You must be Shadow, probably. I'll have you throw a remedy on yourself. Realm must have been inflicted with something because you didn't show up. Okay, she was berserked. No big D. Okay, so this should be Shadow. And I just got Gravaged with no chance of getting people's turns up in time for me to deal with it. So I'm guessing it's goodbye to another X Potion. Remedy, Phoenix Sound, Tonic, Elixir, Ether, X Potion. Oh, I was wrong. Somebody's turn would have come up in time. But it is not a good idea to mess with reality on these things. I shall be regening Setzer because there's a good chance he's been inflicted with Seizure at this point. Because he's eaten like 3 Mind Blasts without dying in the middle. So, you know, it's kind of not very conducive to a balanced breakfast, and sketch him getting the damage off. I'm making headway as fast as I could theoretically be making headway here, but what am I doing? I should stay out of the menu. Raise, that's a bummer. Oh, darn. This is Shadow. And I haven't even gotten to throw a single throwing item yet. Wait, was that an actual turn? Less darn. Whoever you are, please cure too. That was Realm. This is Shadow, but I shall have him bide him his time, because Realm could very easily die at this very moment. She did not. I feel like I'm getting more turns now, so I think Slow connected correctly. I don't think I need to worry about that Grav Bomb, because Setzer is at the ready and willing, and then Setzer shall fire that off, and hopefully I won't get uber murdered by full power there. I did not, so wait for Setzer to go and then have Realm use her sketch. Lots of things to say. It's funny, when I actually tried to script my dialogue during that halfway script, during that Mega Man speedrun thing, I felt like I was speaking a lot slower than I am now, even though my dialogue is obviously not really dialogue, because it's not really scripted. Just have everyone get ready to go. Mind Blast as completely expected. Wait, who are you? Does not matter. Check a remedy on yourself. The first person who I said who are you for was Shadow. The second one was Celeste. Actually, I did not say who are you the second time around, but details, right? That does not tell me anything, actually. Okay, this is Realm. So, there's actually a decent chance that Setzer got stopped at that rate. Which means I should maybe have used that turn to... It doesn't matter, Shadow's turn should come up fast enough, and I should be able to remedy Realm with Shadow before anything goes wrong, and hopefully Setzer will be out of his funk by then. Okay, hopefully that went okay. Actually, that's actually perfect timing if Realm got glared, because she just got it removed from her, and it doesn't matter too much if she gets hit by an Earth spell, because she has that element thanks to her tabby thingamajigger. So I shall have Setzer throw on some remedy. I mean, why do I did that last time too. I called it, I said I'd put on some remedy status, when obviously there's some issues with that. Where's Celeste? Is she just slow? I think she might just be a little bit slow. Uh-oh. No, maybe I was perhaps wrong. I'll be waiting here. Who are you? Are you Celeste or Shadow? Oh good, it is Celeste. Celeste? I just pressed the R button for no reason. Celeste, please, okay, I think, Realm might be dead, thanks to the fact that she's not sketching and being all MIA, so I'm going to Phoenix Down Realm, and hopefully I'll get that off before... No, darn it. Oh no, what? Uh-oh, this is bad, this is very bad. What happened to Shadow? Shadow. No, don't do that, that's a powerful attack.
This could be bad.
Okay, this is less. Not good, not good at all. Phoenix down, Shadow, please. You are Realm. I think I'll have you throw an X potion. Remedy, Phoenix down, Tonic, Elixir, Ether, X potion. I need your healing, Realm. Okay, good. Setzer's alive. I don't usually use Realm to heal, but I'd say. I miss a perfect opportunity to make a. I don't usually do this, but when I do, joke. Alright. Set region. Oh wow, Setzer's out of MP. Not good timing, not good timing really, but. Remedy, Phoenix down, Tonic, Elixir, Ether. He just got X. He just got a lit X potion, so he should be at a decent HP at least, hopefully. Oh man. Actually, that's okay, because it buys me some time. Come on, no! Stop wasting time! Okay, this is Shadow, and he's still got his throw menu available, but I hate the fight command. It means I have to panic and do things wrong. This is Realm, let's see if she can sketch. This is someone who has an item command ready, so I'll just have them throw an item. Dang it, raise. This should be Shadow, right? This is indeed Shadow. Setzer does not seem to be on the board right now. Okay, he just threw his elixir. Oh no! Did you have to raise? It did not hit Shadow. Let's use Float. Kill as many birds as I can with one stone and see if who's alive and get Float on people who are alive. Oh boy, this is not going nearly as smoothly as it did last time. Oh gosh, that was the fight command. I wasted time. Oh no, and I forgot to pay attention. Well, Realm is still alive, that's good news. But I don't know if I'll get my Cure 2 off when I was supposed to, so that. It doesn't help much. Setzer, you stay at the ready. We'll see what happens. See how things go, because this is not going super well. Aww. Holy cow, everyone is alive! That is a miracle. I'd say a Christmas miracle, but it's long gone Christmas by now. And it's now seeming like that full power was an actual attack, so it's less bad and more good, I say. Region yourself, please. Celeste should be probably close to out of MP, so I'm gonna have Shadow deal with that. Shadow. I made a dumb mistake there. Shadow, you should be on magic because you used float. Everything was as I predicted it. Remedy, Phoenix down, Tonic, Elixir, Ether. Realm, you are having your turn right now and you can sketch. Celeste should be a bit slow, but that's only to be expected. Celeste, you bide your time, please. Don't need to be making any snap decisions here. Okay, this should be Shadow. Where were you? You were on item because you used an Ether thingy-majig. Remedy yourself, please. Not such a good time for the remedy. Let's see if Realm clocks in or decides to skip out on work today. I could say that she's sleeping in for work, but that pun only works if she's on sleep status, and she's on Berserk, apparently. Alright, so Setzer has decided to show up. I think it's Setzer. Yep. So Setzer will need to put a remedy on Realm. This should probably be Shadow. As expected. So Shadow, throw stuff. When you don't get your way, throw things. That's generally a good policy to follow in most things relating to general life. Region yourself in the face. And let's see if Realm gets a turn in. Wow, she... Well, Celeste did not die. Shadow did not die either. I could be in bad condition. I don't really know. Does Setzer have a turn coming up? I think he should. Throw a Phoenix down on Realm in case she died. Wonderful, she did not, so I wasted my turn. Actually, it's still good that she didn't die, but... just a little irritating that I jumped the gun on that one. You cure two the party, you should get that off on time. Should hopefully not be eating death thanks to full power if it gets used. And so this should be Celeste, I think. No! What happened? No! I hate Life Shaver, it's so powerful. Oh no, this is bad. Realm's the least likely to be dead, I think. The only good thing I can say about this run is that I haven't seen any Meteo yet, but I'd say it's likely that Celeste died. I was wrong again, which means Shadow's dead. Phoenix down, Shadow. Alright, that's good. It's an actually very okay turn. Who are you? That tells me nothing. You are Shadow. I do believe I shall be throwing an explosion. Remedy, Phoenix down. Tonic. Actually, I think Realm might in fact be dead. So she's gonna need that Phoenix down. This is Setzer. Please get that cure 2 off in time for all my needs and purposes. And I think I'll be needing a float sometime soon. Oh no. Remedy. Remedy. Let's scroll down to the bottom. This is in fact Realm, so let's sketch and see if things go right. No rays. Waste of time, man. No! Stop hitting me with powerful things! Darn it! Okay, this is Shadow. Phoenix down. Celeste came up. She's also on item. She should scroll up to the top. She should use Cure 2. At least she'll get that in, and then I can have Setzer bide his time. Now, if you'd stop get offing realm, I could get some more damage out. Alright. Alright, let's use float. Let's see what happens. See how my cards fall. It says his turn, which isn't a good sign for Realm's existence. Because I really think Realm should have come up first. Nope, I was wrong. I wasted Seth's turn because of that. Sketch, get my damage off. I'm gonna need to buy some time with the X Potion. Remedy, Phoenix Sound, Tonic, Elixir, Ether, Exilether, X Potion. Have Shadow Bite his time. Oh, you. Shadow's dead. You're already on Phoenix Down, Setzer. But it's a good idea to do that. Just yet. I think we're gonna need to start off with a Cure 2 here. Realm dodged it. Sketch away. I'm gonna have Celeste bide her time. I can't tell exactly what to do just yet. I should have waited for Setzer to go before I had Realm. Okay, Shadow will dodge that. And I'll get plenty of time out of the deal. Wait, Celeste is where? She's on... She used... did she do last turn? I totally forget. She used an X potion, yeah, that's right. Remedy, Phoenix down. Get Shadow on his feet. I'm being dumb. Remedy on Realm. Realm's actually still okay. Except she was imped because that moved her off of her sketch menu. Oh gosh, that was Realm. Well, that sucks. I just chucked him a remedy on Setzer that 90% sure got wasted. Now Remedy Realm. I think I need a float. Good, wasted turn. No, he off. No, oh, I spoke too soon. Really? Had to do that, man. This has to be Celeste. I think I need to cure two. It's just too convenient if I get Shadow up. I'm going to revive him. Come on, what did I do that for? Oh, come on, what is going on? I hate the fight command. It's so irritating, it doesn't give me any time to think. This is Realm, but... and I don't know where Celeste's Cure 2 was, because I wasn't paying attention. This is going downhill fast. Five Shadow. Setzer could very easily have died anyway. I don't have any guarantee on that. He survived. I'm gonna have to hope for a lot of wasted turns here. Oh. It's not a wasted turn. There's too many people off of... I really think I'm gonna die now. Please get Phoenix down off first. No.
Realm is not the best candidate to still be alive.
There's not a lot of attacks that are wasted turns at this point because I don't have my float. That is possibly one of them, but not if it hits Realm. Okay, it did not hit Realm. Get Shadow back on his feet. We might have something going here. Shadow probably needs the MP anyway, so when he's back on his feet, I'm gonna chuck an elixir at him. Oh, you. Stop attacking. Alright, let's see. Does Realm still get the Phoenix down off? Still on the right side of the field, too, so she's not confused. Remedy. Phoenix down, tonic, elixir. Now, let's hope I can get float up and then start things going again. Okay, this is Shadow. Don't want to mess that up. Regen yourself, please. Alright. Thank you for doing nothing. Much appreciated. Everyone is back on their feet, everyone is back on float, someone's getting regen, by someone I mean Celeste. Oh, say what? Who is this? What did I do with your turn, Realm? That's where you bide your time. I wouldn't mind having a turn after all that. Alright, now that probably covered just most of the regen damage that happened during that whole res loop issue. If that hits Setzer or Realm, Celeste is probably really good. If it hits someone else, it's probably really bad. This is likely Shadow. Yeah, as expected. Let's wait till Setzer gets his cure off, because I want to know whether I need to revive Realm or not. Come on, Setzer, any day now. No, don't tell me Setzer's dead. I didn't think he would be, but... Throw an elixir at Setzer now. Remedy, Phoenix Down, tonic. Elixir on Setzer. You sketch. Please go well. Well, I elixired Setzer, that's good news. And I managed to get my sketch off. So that turn went. Despite how scary that turn was, could have been a lot worse. Hopefully that it was his actual turn. It was not. Shoot. Okay, Shadow's dead. I know that, so he should be a lot easier to revive than he otherwise could have been. So you use Cure 2? Oh, that's dangerous. What if I am wrong about Celeste's turn? I likely wasn't, but... Cure 2, everyone. That'll be enough for Shadow, anyway. And then I'll have time to get more damage off. Shadow should have come up first. Shadow should be on the item menu, as expected. I think he might use Mind Blast this turn. I was indeed correct. So, Setzer, you just used something... Well, great. That narrows it down substantially. I think you're on magic. You remedy Realm, because there's likely something wrong with her. You remedy Shadow. I had Shadow and Celeste target each other just in case one was on stop. And Realm's still getting damage off. Nice. Making a little bit more progress than I was 30 seconds ago, that's for sure. Well, it's a lot longer than 30 seconds ago, but you get my drift. I think I have time to throw something. So throw something it is. I was wrong. Used Glare. Alright. Setzer's still doing absolutely great on MP. That turn buys me the time to set up my regen, which always makes everything much safer, and because I don't have to worry about seizure ticking away my HP or something crazy like that going on. Just kind of got to be in the zone with this fight. Can't take everything by ear. No easy strats here, but it's doable. It's certainly doable, and I'm definitely making progress. 2 throws in 1 turn. Alright, that was probably not his turn. That was Ray's. Alright, my whole streak of nothing going wrong might be over. Alright, this is Celeste, so I want her to be on the ball. Nice! Okay, I'll have her remedy herself because I actually don't need the turns too badly right now. Oops, this is probably Shadow, we missed the row menu. I actually don't need the turns so badly, and she might be on poison. I'll just have those two go first. Realm, you sketch away. I've done more damage with sketch than throw, so it's unlikely I'll have to worry about running out of throwing items. That's what I think anyway. Kind of have to go to the washroom at this point, but I'm sure not going to mess with that now. Wait till this fight is over, one way or another. Okay, this is probably Shadow. Gotta get him out of his throw menu before... Remedy down to the Realm. You are Celeste, and you are on magic, right? No, you are on remedy, because that's exactly what you did last turn. 2 turns in a row. Well, except this time you're using it on Shadow. Please copy yourself. If I'm lucky, Realm has not had any issues. It appears that I was not lucky, but hey, what can I do? Yeah, Realm was berserked. Alright, now hopefully Realm was not hit by that, and I can just keep the ball rolling. And the fact that Setzer came up first, is that indicative of, what does that mean? I'm gonna throw a remedy on Realm, just in case, because I don't need your turn for any- Oh yeah, I could use it for regen, but... I was wrong, Realm was not glared. Well, I wasn't really wrong. I was actually right. My paranoia was wrong, and, you know, he's usually wrong, so Celeste is almost out of MP, so... Oh, Celeste is out of MP. Good thing I've got the time. It's ironic that I have the time, because I'm not really wearing a watch right now, but I'll throw in a... I can throw an elixir, just because you might be on seizure and you might be taking... Yes, he died! So much big! I was not expecting that. I felt like I was a lot farther behind, but I was just kind of, like, focused on the battle, you know? And, you know, I'm just gonna leave this recording running and go to the washroom and inevitably forget to edit this out like an idiot. So I'm gonna be putting an annotation at the top left, apologizing profusely and just mentioning how sorry I am. But goodbye. Alright, this is it. This is where all the cards lie, and I mean, that's not really a phrase, but... I've been in this position before, and I blew it last time, partly due to bad luck, but partly due to the fact that I'm not going to be playing it the same way this time around. Last time I tried to get back to the save point, and got murdered for it, so I decided to getting back without Shadow is actually a lot harder. And because I don't have as many people to take hits and turns and all of that. So, I've decided to change tactics, and I'm going to just be going forward. Just go for the gold here. Alright. First, Phoenix down. Pretty sure nobody's dead. That's that out of the way. Anyone need a remedy? Nope. Poison status would be bad. Blind status, not so much. Down to tonic. Nobody needed healing, because I generally have to keep my healing ready in that fight. Phoenix down, tonic, elixir, ether, X-potion, Phoenix tier, tincture. Sus is at the top, Rama is at the bottom. She did not get hit by Rasp, so she is not missing any MP. So I'll just... Why am I doing that? There's literally no reason to do that. I do not need my MP in the next segment on either of those two at all, so I just threw away, like, 2,000 gil. Good work, me. Alright, one out of five things done. I made sure to make a count of how many things I have to do, because otherwise I know I'm gonna forget a thing. Two out of five things are complete. I should really hope there are no hitches at this point. Alright, item, skills, equip. Equip, weapon slot, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8. This is Celeste. Now, as you can see, I've never done that before. I never thought of it before because I don't usually actually have a reason to scroll down to the bottom of the weapon menu, so I never thought of actually doing that. But it's a way of telling who it got there. And believe it or not, I had to kill Atma Weapon on a completely separate test run unblindfolded just because I needed to practice this menuing segment after I had gotten the actual Atma weapon in my inventory, because I didn't... There's no way to tell exactly where it would be. But three down. That should be the electric blade. Equip. Down one to Setzer. Equip. Weapon slot. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. As expected, it is Setzer. Just want to make sure to absolutely sure to double check which character it is, because 99% of my mistakes in menu come from trying to do things with the wrong character and just end up essentially throwing garbage data at it, for lack of a better term. This also confirms everything else went smoothly in my menuing. 2, 1, 2, 3. These guys use Storm, so I'll throw on the Gator Hide. It's not super important. It's actually mostly just a tonic saver, rather than a lifesaver. So we've got Relic. It should be on Realm right now, because that. The Relics are not quite as important. Equip, top thing, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I'm shoving the Black Belt on Realm. Yes, the Black Belt is on Realm. I can just imagine her doing all of that karate right now. Relic, go down to Celeste. Equip. Select top thing. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. All of these relics are mainly just meant to be minor boosts, so if I do mess up the relics, it's probably not going to get me killed. Relic. Down to Setzer. Equip. Down one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay. So, here we go. This music is just kind of tense. Even in a regular game, this part of the game just feels so climactic. It just has that intensity, you know? But and usually, any emotions that you get from the story are kind of destroyed by the whole lack of being able to see the cutscenes. But here, it's something I don't want to lose at this point. So, yeah. Alright, the good thing about this time segment, being blindfolded barely affects anything. Like, you'd be really surprised how little of a difference it makes. Because you get so much guidance in the walking that the walking makes almost no difference. The battles are pretty much all holding A, so, I mean, you can't hold A any faster. That would be pretty impressive to hold A better with your eyes open than with your eyes closed, but that's kind of not really a thing. So the battles are almost as fast. The only issue is getting my cursors to start up. And for some reason, my cursors were weirdly seemed to be reset after Atma weapon in my test run. So I'm not sure if they reset strangely or not. But I'm going to assume that they don't, and that I, for some reason, moved my cursors around in a random encounter. I don't know why I'd do that, because it wrecks the test, but I honestly couldn't think of a reason why anything else would be the case. And I've essentially just got to get everyone to the attack command, and that's the most time-wasty thing. Oh, and my menuing is also a lot slower. But believe it or not, my first test run that I did with my eyes open and just was pretty sloppy, used a lot of fast-forward, it was actually slower than one of my later test runs with my eyes closed, where I had like a minute 45 left at the end. The danger is, though, if I make a mistake, then, yeah, it can eat up a lot of time. Even just the smallest mistake can eat up a lot of time. But the good news is there's not much luck involved. Oh, and of course the boss fight takes up a lot of time, and that's not going to be sped up by having your eyes open either, so... That's why I'm thinking it's probably, well, not only is it probably easier than going back to the save point, I also get to kill two birds with one stone and get to go to the next segment already. So, I mean, two for one deal. You can find that at, like, probably almost any supermarket, even though they probably just make it cost twice as much, and they say, 2 for 1, it's amazing, just buy this thing. Weird, I'm starting to get kind of hungry. It's only 3:30, I don't usually get hungry at this point. Perhaps a side effect of nerves, maybe? But you know, I gotta have confidence that I'm gonna get this. Otherwise, I'm just gonna slip up. Actually, this cutscene's giving me a lot of time to calm my nerves a little bit, even though, you know, this isn't the best cutscene to do that with. Navigating outside of Sid's house is obviously a non-issue, so if I make it to the end of the floating continent to the cutscenes at the end, I've made it. Oh yeah, and if Shadow's not dead. If Shadow dies, that would be a pretty dumb mistake on my part. Because it's actually pretty easy to avoid him dying in that menu. So where are my curses, just for reference? The problem is, I wasn't thinking at the end of the battle. Celeste and Zetzer could just as easily be on magic. At least I'll know who Celeste is. As strange as a sentence like that sounds to say. And the fact that I threw a tincture on Zetzer may not be incredibly useless after all, because it'll mean that I'll be able to tell if he's in his magic menu. Goodbye, Gustav. You shall be missed. By, like, one guy in your army who actually didn't realize you were a totalitarian dictator and hadn't done his political studies very well and probably should become a more learned person overall. But, you know, can't blame him, I guess, if you're living in a propaganda-filled society. Lots of rumbling. This is getting intense. The good news is, I've essentially got a minute and a half of leeway to get my curses all sorted out at the beginning, so I'm not worried about that taking up too much time, as long as I don't make any mistakes. As long as I don't make any huge mistakes that could end this. Mistakes that I don't know what they'd be, but the whole point of not knowing, expecting the unexpected is that it's unexpected in the first place, so. Alright, here we go. Things are about to start soon, because I just got knocked off. There's an Arapa going over there. I perhaps should call him Nymphu, considering the. Okay, any second now, the music's gonna start up to tell me that we are starting to go and run. A little bit off key there, but. I can afford to be sloppy with my movements there. I can afford to be sloppy with my movements here as well. I hear more rumbling. Haven't gotten a battle yet. Alright, here's the moment of truth in many, many ways. Alright, so let's see whose turn comes first and go from there. Alright, so it is either Realm or Setzer. Realm or Setzer is probably on sketch or magic. That's what I'm thinking anyway. Yeah, it appears my curses are reset. Oh, I got a proc. That's both good and bad, because on the first fight at least. Oh shoot, I'm an idiot. I forgot to reset my cursor. 1, 2, 3. Can't waste this time. Come on, please, just give me the save menu already. I think that might have been the item menu. No, it was not. There we go. Alright. A long way to the top left. Middle of the top right. I think, actually, my cursors really did get reset. It's really weird. Hopefully I didn't waste too much time there. Nice job, Realm. You're a credit to something. Little girls, I guess. All the way down, all the way right. It's rumbly noise number two. Then we'll get to rumbling noise number 3. The battles seem to be in very fixed spots in here. I don't know why, but the battles here are strange. I'm not sure exactly what guides where they are, but... that's a death. Rumbling noise number 3. Get to the staircase. Another rumbling noise. All the way down. All the way like that. Alright, is this Narappa? Or is this another Bat Lady? This is another Bat Lady. Shucks, I thought I had already made it to him. And I just says shucks unironically. Dead! I'm actually not sure why Realm's getting hurt, but... alright, now is this Narappa? I think I wouldn't have walked so far if it isn't, so... I think this might be. I can probably expect a battle after him, because I've gotten less battles than I usually do. This is just a long, interactive cutscene, and I'm not so worried about it. But yeah, it's really, really strange that my cursors get reset. I honestly am baffled as to why that happens. It's not something that you'd even notice usually, but... this is like the one playthrough where you might actually notice such a strange and unnecessary detail. Alright, after this battle, I revive Setzer and Realm, just in case I get another Bat Lady, because otherwise the Bat Lady fight could take ages, and I don't have ages. I always get scared hearing these really powerful attacks, like, oh no, I'm still gonna die, but it's like, no, Celeste is invincible, don't worry, no need to panic. Nothing is going wrong here. Yeah, gosh. I don't want to wait through this battle. One more attack from Celeste will do him in. This is just a strange fight because I don't need to worry about what the attacks are. I don't need to worry about getting hit. It's just kind of something that you don't normally have going for you, I guess. Alright, that's it for you. I totally destroyed you. What's that? Alright. I think despite that menu kerfuffle at the beginning, I should be okay. Should being the operative word. The operative word that I hate using. Alright, run all the way up there. Down and right a whole lot. Alright, now I wait. Okay, all the signs say that this has gone correctly. But the thing is, I've got like a minute and a half. Well, probably more like a minute thanks to that kerfuffle beginning to wait here. I'll get a noise either way, telling me what happened. But, all the signs say I did it correctly. But, you know, there's always just that inkling of doubt that I completely misread something, that something went horribly wrong, and I'm just standing here waiting to die because of that mistake. It's kind of aggravating in a way, but... I mean, can't really have any certainty in this type of run. Can't have any certainty going for you. The only certainty I've got is that my cat's here and he's saying hello. Hello, Wesley. Say hello to the camera. Nah, you're not gonna make noise right now. You can sit on my leg if you want. Come on over. Waiting here is just... you better not go near the laptop. I don't want you messing with anything. It'd be a real shame if you hit the rewind button and messed with this whole thing. Stay away from there. I know you want to see the laptop. Sit on my leg. Come on. Hen? Yes! There's that noise I was looking for. That's the noise of Shadow appearing and saying hello and... things happening. Ooh boy, I made it. It's weird, it feels a lot scarier going through the... floating continent. I mean, like, the time segment afterwards. Even though the time segment isn't hard, it's actually a lot easier than going back to the save point. Despite the blindfolded nature of this challenge,
but I honestly wouldn't have guessed that, because time segments in the past have always been such an issue. The Opera House was the other one. The second half of the Opera House never gave me any issues, but the first half of the Opera House, I failed that once. The Imperial Base, I didn't fail, but that was an absolute miracle. And there was another... Gosh, I'm totally forgetting now. The getting through the Battle of Narsh and the BFLLG, that was a pain, but this time segment, smooth as silk. And now we get to a new world. I guess you could even say, puts on sunglasses, that this is a brave new world. Yeah! Time to go through more cutscenes. Stay away from there. Don't probably need to menu trick yet. I mean, at least got until the wind comes in, fades in, shows me a couple pictures of the deserted island after panning in on the overworld. But I made the overworld map for Return of the Dark Sorcerer. I'm actually surprised I remembered that it pans in here and made allowances for that by making all water underneath the solitary island's new form. Yeah, my solitary island is actually just crams a little bit of, like, everything. It's got a little tiny desert, a little weeny forest, a little mountain, and unlike in vanilla where it uses a tree to signify the mountain for some reason, I was like, yeah, that's kind of weird, so I made an actual mountain for it. Although, after I got to the end, I realized it looks kind of like a stormy thundercloud almost. It's kind of weird. Or maybe, like, a brain with a lightning bolt symbol that they have on Scribble Knots as one of the achievements you can get for using all new items in a level. I'm not sure why that immediately comes to mind, but it does fit the image kind of well. I'm not sure why I'm talking about the overworld map for Return of the Dark Sorcerer of all things, but, you know, I might as well fill the time with something because there's nothing going on here anyway. Nirapa doesn't give you XP anymore, so no need to deal with that, you know, little geez. Not that this thing isn't obsolete and the whole thing with the no AXP eggs and all that jazz, but I'm definitely, like, talking a lot more than during these, for, like, commentary than I did at the beginning. You'd think it would be harder to keep up commentary if you can't actually see what's going on, but it's not any harder, really. In fact, it might even be easier, because I would have expected myself to not be talking a whole lot, because, you know, I'm not very, like, when I'm just making small talk, I'm not very good at that. I made it to still can't open my menu. Hello, Sid, please just start dying already so that I can leave this place. You know, just saying. This cutscene is very, very long. The thing about this next part is Sid is certainly going to be dying. Mixing together timed parts, NPCs that move, and I have to talk to, repetitive going back and forth, that's all the worst things you can add to this challenge, so yeah, even if I really cared about saving Sid, I wouldn't. There's just no way. It wouldn't be as hard as dodging the... there we go. It wouldn't be as hard as dodging the rats in the BFLLG, which is why I called a mulligan on that one, but it's sort of like comparing the impossibleness of climbing Mount Everest in shorts to the impossibleness of casting fire on something. Here we go. It's the overworld. I'm on the item because I was using that. Oh man, this segment is over. Let's see how long that took. Hour and a half. Man. Oh boy. It's definitely a lot faster than it could have been. I know one of my fails took an hour and a half on its own because I got stuck in a 20-minute res loop. And that was the one where I got within 500 HP of killing him. So yeah, that was a real pain, but not as painful as the one after that where I died on the way back to the save point. See you next time!